Lord Jesus, help us to become one with you each and every day, such that we can each be little lights of yours in this world. In Christ's name, amen. Good job of crossing. That's nice. Our first communion to learn how to cross themselves. It's good to see you. Now, one last thing, and then you guys can go back with your families. So, all during Easter, we had this special hymn that we had. It's called the Paschal Hymn. The Paschal Candle. It's a big candle right here. And the Paschal Candle reminds us of Jesus being risen from the grave and being among us in his bodily form, right? As a person just like we are. Okay? But we just said, when Jesus ascends, he returns to God the Father. He becomes one with God. And so he is everywhere, in all times, in all places. He's no longer in one body anymore. He's in all of us. And so, today, on Ascension Day, we put this candle out right now. And we watch that one flame that is Jesus become that smoke. It that goes and it becomes a part of everything. Part of the air, part of the air we breathe, and that is the symbol for us of becoming one with God too. Alrighty, guys, go back, sit with your family. For those of you who are going to have communion, first communion, I'll call you up in just a minute. So these three young people are taking their next step in their journey of faith. We have James Galvin, David Cheris, and Tony Sparta, who will be receiving their first Instructed Communion today. So we are going to have them kneel here as we prepare and say the Eucharistic prayer. And again, as we are praying and preparing to receive communion together, I ask you to include these young people in your prayers as they take this vital next step in their own journeys of faith, becoming one step closer to mature Christians. Guys, we are so proud of you. God bless you. And I hope that this day guides your feet in Christians. Walk in love as Christ loved us. He gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice unto Almighty God.
to his command, O Father. We remember
his death. We proclaim his resurrection.
Now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say together,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah.
I'll ask the adults just to stand in place for a moment, please, while we communicate these questions. James, this is the body of Christ. This is the body of Christ, the bread of God. Let us all together say, Amen.
Amen.
Please move. Holy and Almighty God, we give you thanks for these young people and for their faith in you, taking these steps. Help them continue to take steps with you in the reading of these Bibles, that their minds might be open to the scriptures as you opened the disciples' minds, that their hearts might be set afire with your love for all people in this world, and that you might strengthen their souls for everything that is to come in their lives as young people, for days good and days that are challenging, that you might be with them and that you might nurture them in the reading of the scriptures, alone and with their families. And so we bless these Bibles in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the blessing of God Almighty be upon each and every one of you, uplifting your spirit.